Hey guys, my name is Richard, and today I want to be talking about creating boundaries. You know, growing up, my family and I, we would love to go camping every summer, and we still do that till this day. And I'll never forget it, there was this one time we were all hanging out by the fire and we were making s'mores, talking and having a great time, and I had my shoes on, and I had my shoes next to the fire, and my dad goes, "Son, take your shoes off. Do not have your shoes by the fire." And I said, "Dad, everything's gonna be okay. I want my shoes to be on. It's totally fine. My feet are cold." And he said, "Son, take your shoes off. Trust me, they will burn." Well, anyways, we're hanging out, talking, conversing, and out of nowhere, I look at my shoes, and my shoes started to burn. You see, I looked at the soles, and the soles of my shoe started to melt, and I said, "Oh no, my shoes are melting." And my father said, "Son, I told you to take off your shoes, because if you don't take off your shoes, they would start to melt." And that's exactly what happened, son. Your shoes started to melt. When I look back and I think about what my father told me, I started to realize something, that my father was actually teaching me about boundaries. You see, he was telling me that if you do not create a boundary, Rich, eventually you'll get burned. And how many of you know that because we haven't set boundaries in our life, we eventually got burned? You see, some of you, maybe you got burned by relationships, or maybe you got burned by friendships, or maybe you got burned in your health, all because you did not set a boundary. You see, when we set a boundary, what it does, it actually protects us. And when we set a boundary, our boundaries show us what we value. And when we set a boundary, our boundaries show us our standards. And if we do not create a boundary, then eventually things in our lives start to diminish and we don't flourish, all because we did not set a boundary. You see, I realized something about people, that people will always cross a line when a line isn't drawn. Friends, if we're going to be prosperous, if our relationships are going to flourish, and if our lives are going to grow and be in fruition, then we have to learn to create boundaries. You see, I love it in the text in the book of Exodus chapter 19. It says something that is just so remarkable, and here's what it teaches us. It says that in Exodus 19:12, it says, "Mark off a boundary all around the mountain. Warn the people, be careful. Do not go up on the mountain or even touch its boundaries. Anyone who touches the mountain will certainly be put to death." I love this passage because God is telling Moses about his boundaries. He's saying, "Moses, make sure you mark off a boundary that nobody goes up to this mountain." And the reason for it, Moses, is that the people, they need to be consecrated. The people, they need to be holy. The people need to fully devote and commit themselves to me, and they need to wash their clothes. And if they don't do this, Moses, they're going to be put to death. What is God doing in this passage? He's showing us what he values, because that's what boundaries do. So the first thought I would want to encourage you to write down is, creating a boundary will show you what you value. In this text, we notice that God values holiness. God values purity. When it comes to your life, what do you value? When it comes to your life, when people look at your life, what is it advertised? Because here's the thought. Whatever you authorize, you advertise. So for instance, if people are walking over you and they're disrespecting you, if you don't say anything, that's what you're advertising. Maybe you're in a relationship and you notice that your man's liking all these photos and it disturbs you, and if you don't say anything to your man, hey, that's what you're advertising. Or maybe some of you here today, you have a cramped schedule, and one thing that you have trouble with is that you don't know how to say no, and so you go and you keep saying yes to all these things, and you're mad and you're frustrated with yourself because you know that you don't have any free time, and you know that you're burdened and you have no peace and you're stressed out, but since you didn't say anything, this is what you advertise. You see, oftentimes we're getting mad at people for treating us this type of way, but we should get mad at ourselves for not saying anything. You know why? Because whatever you authorize, you advertise. Whatever you permit is what you promote. You see, if you don't like what you're attracting, then you have to change what you're promoting. You need to set some boundaries. Your boundaries show you what you value. So I'm going to reiterate this question again. What are your boundaries? What do you value? You see, friends, I've noticed that people who have a boundary problem are people who have a value problem. If you don't value yourself, then anybody can treat you the way that they want to treat you. And some of you might say, well, Rich, that's not right, because they should treat me love, honor, and respect. And in all honesty, I agree with you, they should. But if I can be real honest with you, a lot of people lack character and integrity. And we can't think that just because this is the way we think is the way that other people are going to think. So we have to learn to establish a boundary. So what is the first point? Creating a boundary will show people what you value. The second thing is this, is that creating a boundary will protect you. You see, I love the passage we read in the book of Exodus chapter 19 verse 12, because God was telling them his boundary that if you climb up to the mountain, or if you even touch the mountain, you'll be put to death. He's saying, what he's trying to teach us is that this boundary will protect you. You see, in your life, your boundary will protect you as well. When you create a boundary in your life, you'll notice that the right people will come into your life and the wrong people will come out of your life. You know why? Because you created a boundary. Some people don't like boundaries because boundaries show people what you're going to put up with and what you simply aren't going to put up with. So what does a boundary do? A boundary protects you. So a boundary will bring right people into your life. And not only that, a boundary will protect you in a plethora of other ways. For instance, maybe with your health. Maybe you have a goal to lose 20 pounds and now you just establish boundaries. What do boundaries do? It protects you to get to your goals. So you know that, man, it's 7:30 at night. I probably can't go to In-N-Out and get a double-double. Why? Because I have a boundary, because I'm trying to lose some weight. Or maybe with your finances, maybe you're struggling, maybe you're in debt. So if you create a boundary and you tell yourself, hey, I can't go shopping out on the weekends anymore. Why? Because I'm creating this boundary because it's protecting me so I don't keep continually getting myself in worse debt. That's what boundaries do. Boundaries protect you. And the third thing that a boundary does is that when you create a boundary will help you to not burn out. You see, I realize that in life, the reason why we have burnout problems is because we have boundary problems. You know, what I love about Jesus, if you look in the Gospels, you'll notice that Jesus often withdrew to lonely places to pray with his Father. And I love that. He would withdraw and he would pray. And I love that because, you know, in the text, you'll notice that there's so many people that are pulling from Jesus, wanting miracles, wanting Jesus' help. But there's times in Jesus' life where he has to withdraw to a lonely place to hang out with his Father. You see, what is Jesus teaching us there is that when you create a boundary, it will help you with burnout. You see, I believe some of you here today, the reason why you are burdened and you're dealing with burnout is because you're not creating a boundary. You know, you're not creating a boundary, a place where you're able to hang out with your Father in that solitude time where you're able to go and worship and you're able to go and pray and to speak to him. And as God speaks to you and minister to you, it helps you with your fire. It gets you refreshed and ignited to go out for more. And maybe some of y'all, when it comes to boundaries, the reason why you're dealing with burnout is that you keep saying yes to so many things, you know. And oftentimes we have to watch over our lives in these areas where we say yes to things, because in all honesty, some of us, we're saying yes to too many things and we're just yes people. Yes, I'll go help you with this, and yes, I'll go help you with that. And maybe the battle that you're facing with, well, Rich, if I don't say yes to these people, maybe they'll leave my life. Or if I don't say yes to these people, maybe they're going to be displeased with me. Well, in all actuality, friends, I want you to say no, because no, your no actually shows people who's really for you. See, when people are for you, they should care about your well-being. They should care about the betterment of yourself. So if you say no to people and they leave your life, well, guess what? That's a blessing for your life. Why? Because you don't need them. You need people that are going to be there for you. You need people that are going to be there to help you, to edify you, to lift you up, to challenge you, and to strengthen you. That's why it's imperative, friends, that we create a boundary, because boundaries will help us. So with this being said, I want to wrap up the three points. What does creating a boundary do? Creating a boundary, the first thing that it does, it will show us what we value. The second thing that a boundary does, it protects us. The third thing that a boundary does is that creating a boundary will help us with burnout. Well, friends, I pray that this video helped you, and I pray that you go and create some boundaries, because boundaries will protect you. They will show you your value, and not only that, they're going to help you with your burnout problem. So anyways, friends, I pray that this video blessed you. We love you. I love you. God bless you.